active flat panel. It's a 4K resolution display with LED backlit. It has a toughened glass over it of 4mm MOS, which is anti-glare, anti-scratch and anti-collision. It has built-in speaker. It has multiple input ports like HDMI, VGA, DP port. Then it has multiple USB ports like 3.0, 2.0. It has built-in Wi-Fi, built-in LAN. It has built-in dual operating system like Android is there, and we have built-in OPS on which you can install Windows or Linux. So this is our whiteboard software. Now using this whiteboard software, we can create our lecture, our notes, our presentation. So here are the tools. Here's the pen. You can select the pen from here. If I want to change the color, I can go to properties, I can select the color. Even I can change the thickness of the pen. If I want to erase the content, I can simply select the eraser and then I can erase the desired content. We have various pens available with us. So one of the pen is magic pen or the shape recognition pen. So any shape we draw freehand will be converted to a perfect shape. In a similar way, we have a pen which is for text recognition. So any text we write freehand will be converted to proper type text. Even we can do same for the numbers like 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. We have the option to add multiple pages. So here's the option, you can click on new page. And here the new page is added. If you want to change the background of the page, you can simply click on insert option background and you can select the desired color. So you have changed the background to green color. If I want to view all my pages, I can click on page list and I will get the view of all my pages. So let's say if I want to switch to page number 2, this is my page number 2. Then let me switch to my page number 4. So with a single click, I can switch between my pages. We have the option to insert any file from the system. You can download the file from the internet, or you can insert any local file. So let's say if I want to insert my image, so I'll just click on image and then select the image. Even I can resize the image very easily. In a similar way, I can add video as well. And here again, I can resize the video. By playing the video, I can do the annotation over the content. I can explain, or even I can create a separate point on my page. We can easily capture any content from a whiteboard as well. Let's say if I want to have a portion of this video, so what I do is I click on the capture button and then I can draw the box around the content. And with a single click, I'll get the screenshot of that particular image. Now we have one more feature which is known as endless canvas. So using this option, we can resize the image, we can resize the content, we can move the content in any direction, and then we can again continue with the writing. You can resize the content, even we can shrink the content and we can place it on one corner of the page, and again we can have different diagrams or any content on the other part of the page. Even we have the option to split the page. So let's say on one portion I want this video to be played, and on the other half I can have my whiteboard. So if I want to play the video, so the video is being played on the one side, and I can use my pen for creating the content on the whiteboard. So now software also has the built-in resource library. So let's say if I want to have image of world map, so I can just simply drag and drop from my library. I can use the pen to mark the location, to mark the city, to mark the continent. Even we have the option to change the background. The subjective background we have building graph, we have Hindi background, science background, English background. So different types of subjective backgrounds are also available. Let's say if I want to use my graphs, I can simply use my pen, I can draw it with point. On this graph background, you can plot the point using the pen and then join the line. Then we have some subjective tools available. We have subjective tools available within a whiteboard software. Like one of the tools is match tool. So I can select compass from here. I can define the radius. And then I can draw angle, sector, or arc using my compass. So I have drawn one angle of 93 degrees. In a similar way, I can use other interactive tools like protector, ruler. So these are the tools that we can use for making straight line, angles, sector. Okay. So under mathematical tools, we have a function tool using which we can draw a graph. So here you can see different functions are available, like linear function, quadratic function, cubic function. So you can select any function from the list. So here I'm selecting linear function. So here I'm taking the default equation. So through which I'm getting a graph. This graph I'm getting. Now again, I'm just taking same linear function and I'm changing the value from 5 to 20. So now here we can see the difference. For mathematical tools, we have a function tool using which we can draw a graph. So here you can see different functions are available, like linear function, quadratic function, cubic function. So you can select any function from the list. So here I'm selecting linear function. So here I'm taking the default equation. So through which I'm getting a graph. This graph I'm getting. Now again, I'm just taking same linear function and I'm changing the value from 5 to 20. So now here we can see the difference. Under mathematical tools, we have a function formula through which we can draw a graph. So here under formula, you can see different functions are available like linear function, quadratic, cubic. So you can select any of the function. So right now I'm selecting linear function. So if I click on OK, I'll get the graph. Now again, I'm selecting linear function, but I will be changing a value. So instead of 5, I'm selecting 20. When I click on OK, so I'll get the respective graph on my page. So here you can see the difference between the graph with different values. Okay. So we have a feature for screen capturing, for screen hiding. So let's say if I move to a page number 2. So here if I want to hide my page, what I can do is I can click on Shape. Then partially I can display my page or the image. The same, this option even I can use for play quiz in the classroom. Apart from this, we have the option for spotlight. Instead of like displaying the complete page, I can display a portion of the image to my students. Even I can capture an area from the screen. Let's say if I want to capture this particular area, so I just draw the square, and in this way I can have crop the image. Even I can minimize my software and I can navigate the background screen. I can annotate, like this is shape. I can annotate over the screen and even I can take the screenshot. So for taking screenshot option, I need to select the capture option. Then if I want to capture this portion, selling dedicated required area, and in this way we can have the screenshot from a video or from a PPT, from PDF file, and even we can do the annotation over this. So once we are done creating our lecture notes, what we do is we can save the file in various formats like WKB, PDF, Doc, so that we can easily share with the students. Even we can encrypt the file, or we can put the password on our file so that only the right person can access it. Even you have the option to print the file or to send the email directly from the software. So these are few points, few tools that are available in our Whiteboard software for making a class more interactive.